It's Madden NFL 22, and the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the Vikings and the Eagles, and it comes your way next.
We're just a stone's throw from the Delaware River, and we've got some water to contend with ourselves. A steady rain falling at Lincoln Financial Field. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly, as they get ready to match up with the Minnesota Vikings. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Eagles team as they interplay here. They've got to be pleased with the start to this season, obviously. A perfect 3-0.
Three good quality wins, too. It's got people in the locker room excited. They're thinking that this could be their year.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Vikings, they were losers their last time out. They're going to try to get back in the win column, but obviously they're going to have to do that in a hostile environment.
And sometimes it actually works to your advantage. Now you've got to band together your team, the us against the world mentality. Let's see if they can use it and get a victory.
Season is in full swing, and we're underway here in week four. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll get this just up past the 20, but a marker is down. Let's get the call.
No.
Now this is going to put him back with a not great field position.
So they really had zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return. Then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
And his first pass is incomplete. The elements here definitely going to be a factor. You're going to have some drop balls playing in conditions like this.
Yeah, you got to minimize them as best you can. That means 100% of your focus has got to be on making the catch, not on what you do afterwards. Look it all the way in first.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming. Now, this defense for the Eagles, they were very solid last week in the victory over Baltimore.
Well, let's face it, when you hold someone to just 6 points in a game, the feeling that you have among your team is that you're not going to lose very many of those. That's the way to get it done.
And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
It's a return of five following a punt of 42 yards. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. So here come the Eagles for their initial possession of the game. And they will be led out by their 6'6" quarterback.
His game last week reminded me of the old song, accentuate the positive, because that's about all he did, right?
Yeah.
Three touchdown passes, over 300 yards in the air, receivers happy.
And they got the win.
Got the win. If you're a running back that likes to catch passes, they're happy as well. Big time game.
Now first down carry by Sanders, well defensed as they'll hold him to just a couple. Second down coming up. The numbers for Sanders last week, 22 carries, a trip to the end zone to go along with 118 yards.
And well-liked by his teammates. In fact, I got on good authority, even though I'm not an investigative reporter, that in their team meeting this week, the offensive line stood up and said, Coach, we've got to have better yardage for this guy. He's number nine in the league. He's got to be in the top three before the season's over. Let's run the ball.
Now here's a throw that's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there, nearly an opening drive, INT. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 17-yard line.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
That's his longest run of the first quarter. And, Charles, we talked before the game about them needing to establish the run game. They'll be looking for more of that.
And they got to the perimeter. So that tells me that that's part of the game plan of what they want to get done today. So they'll have some complimentary runs where he'll run it to the inside. But it appears that when they want the big yardage.
And this is caught. Touchdown. Fire. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Taken at about the one. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. And the Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. Three and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit
better.
Sometimes
it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
Now a throw here to his running back. Now he'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook.
We got this.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Cook with a run on first down, but he'll only manage a couple there before he's taken down. Second and 8 coming up. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. To the sideline, and it's caught, but boy, he's out of bounds. And they try to get him into space coming out of the backfield, but it'll be third down. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. They'll look to throw. Lets it fly for Thielen. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. A big play that time through the air. 37 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. They'll look to throw again. Pass incomplete.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him. Made it very tough for him to get the ball.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he will find his man on the end round. And they're going to drop him well shy of the first as he can only make it to the 11. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. The kick by Bass is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defense is awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the turn.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past him.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they? But they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be bought in with what we're doing. Come on, let's get on board.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And this is caught by Watkins. And some space here. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession. After 1-7-3 the score on EA Sports. They'll run on first down. Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. So the drive there took 6 plays. And it was Miles Sanders who finished it off with a touchdown run. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Kenny Nwagu now out of his end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And Cook getting the call there on first down as he works his way through for a nice gain of 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage. I know I spend a lot of time talking about how tight ends in a lot of cases now are pumped up wide receivers, but they're still big people. He used that frame right there to absorb a really big hit on him and held on to the ball.
And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And it'll be third down. Back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. It gets by him, and now a little daylight. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A big play there on the catch and run.
And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we can at least put this one in our top five. That was a determined gallop there.
And he's brought down.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
Cook will take this into the end zone for a Viking touchdown.
So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Extra point by Bass, up and good.
And the lead is down to 4. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
On the move to his left. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time. And I think we were both wondering, once he got out of the box, whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Here's 2nd and 8.
That swung out wide to Sanders.
Oh, able to avoid him. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. A big play that time on the catch and run.
Tell you what, partner, you get the football in his hands, just give him a little bit of open space. As we just saw, he can make you pay.
And he wasn't the top option there, but check down, turned into first down, and then some.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up 2nd down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on 3rd down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Out to his left. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle is going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
So a nice kick there as they add 3 to the lead.
And from what I've seen so far, Brandon, I think they've been the better of the two teams here in the first half. So even though you want the touchdown, I think that's a nice job there to put 3 points on the board.
No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25.
And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. First month of the season, those numbers pretty solid. Does he continue that?
I think so, because when you come out of the gate this strong, that means that you have planned for it and you like the results that you're getting. So I wouldn't have any doubt that the head coach, offensive coordinator, actually called him in and said, look, you're our guy, okay? We're going to continue to stick with this as long as we're winning games. You ready for the challenge? And then they presented it to the rest of the team. I think we'll see plenty of that as this season moves on.
And I'm sure he said challenge accepted. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
7 yards, the pickup there. The Vikings in the hurry up. They're hustling up to the line. And Cook has it, left side. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Back to throw again. And this is going to be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball. But surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Fair catch called for and taken just inside the 10-yard line. 35 yards that time on the punt. And the Eagles will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity. All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it can...
Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. They'll drop to throw. It's caught by Sanders and able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. They'll look to throw now on first down. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Second and 9 now. And he's brought down after a very nice game. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Again, he'll drop to throw.
Trying for Sanders, but this is intercepted. It's David Arnett picking it off. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get him with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll look to throw here. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And they move this all the way down to the 9. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. This is a 26-yard attempt. The kick by Bass is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've come to half. All right, folks, eager to get back to this week 4 matchup? We won't put up a fight. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Eagles ready to go on offense to begin this third quarter. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Second half will start with a run by Sanders. And he's taken down. It's a gain of 3 from the 17 to the 20.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It's only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now a throw here, hauled in, and he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. To throw now on first down. Airing it out deep for Smith. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big connection on that one. 30 yards. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back there and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The ball comes out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. This is Smith with a grab. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. They'll set up to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now 3rd down coming up.
Not only was that a terrific play, but that loss of yardage they created this close to their own goal line, that gives them a little breathing room now as they move them back.
And they're breathing fire a little bit right now, aren't they?
A lot of confidence being shown by them at this point of the game.
Toward the pylon, caught. They wind up with six on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. Now back to throw. Yeah, that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Sanders, and he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Well, it's apparent the defense understands the situation. They have to keep them out of the end zone here. That's a great start by them. A loss on that play. Can they force them into a field goal attempt and still give their offense an opportunity?
Sanders again. And this time he's going backwards. So after the no gain on the last attempt, here they get him behind the line. Can this Vikings D hold up one more time? Third and goal. He'll drop to throw. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Say hello to Eric Kendricks. He gets the sack there. So that time, Charles, quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly. Oh, he left this one out to the right. That's a bad miss. No good. And this score will stay right where it is. So they'll come away with nothing here. A disappointing result even on a day like this.
And as a kicker in the rain, you've got to slow things down a little bit. Give your holder an extra half second to make sure everything's secure. And here, he might have rushed this one a little, and it winds up no good.
And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
On second down, it's Cook again. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. There's the stiff arm, and he's got this down to the 35. 54 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they construct.
And this is going to be intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and the Eagles are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Now, they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
And he can't quite bring it in. Might have heard footsteps there across the middle. Second down.
Well, he'll definitely say that that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Looking here for Smith downfield. And he is caught at the 10-yard line. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Devontae Smith with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Eagles are about to make it 4 straight as they add to this fourth quarter advantage. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. So that drive, 4 plays. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Minnesota's offense takes over possession. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. They'll dump this off to Cook. Not much there, only a yard.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. He'll look to throw. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play there for Minnesota. In today's NFL, you know, we talk about quarterbacks and their speed and accuracy, but there's still something about a guy slinging one downfield. On first down, it's Cook. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Looking to throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. They'll look to throw. Open man is Thielen, is complete. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. And in a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Vikings have made it a 1-score game again here in the fourth. And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. So tried to throw it in for 2 points, but the D got home, brought him down.
Yeah, got home, which means it had to be good coverage, just had nowhere to go with the ball. Typically, you're trying to throw quick hitters, quick slants, you know, maybe even a quick fade. Nothing was open. He ends up getting sacked. Let's go.
So here are the Eagles to take over. They're on a 3-game winning streak, and right now looking good in this one as well. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29. run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
64 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries. They'll look to throw here on first down. And this is caught by Watkins. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
They'll go again with Sanders. And looking for a lane, but none to be found for Sanders as they stop him short of the line to gain. Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
But that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number 1.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Flush to his right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. The defensive end, Daniil Hunter, drops him. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a 1-score game. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They're facing a critical 3rd down now as they try to hold on to this lead. Looking for the end zone. And this one dropped in the end zone. Looked like a touchdown, but not to be. And now it's 4th down. Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have 1 right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribe, right? When we talk about winning that turnover battle, that evens things out, especially for a road team, especially for a team that's an underdog.
And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. So all eyes on this Vikings offense, down on the scoreboard. And time, a huge factor. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. He's back to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Smith. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down. Back to throw. Able to find Thielen. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the 1st down. Got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understand where they are in the field?
He'll look to throw. Completes this to Jefferson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. throw left side on target to Thielen. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll look to throw. And oh, that one nearly intercepted. That would have sealed it. Instead, it'll be second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this will be caught. Touchdown. So in the final minute here, now a two-point conversion will tie the game.
The touchdown's massive, but now they've got to have two to possibly take this to overtime.
Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They're going to try and run for it. And he's going to get into the end zone. The two-point conversion successful. And we've got ourselves a tie football game. Boy, hard to ask for a better game thus far. 27 apiece is our score as the kick's away. Fielded right around the 8. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Called it the 21. Now back to work for Miles Sanders in the Philly offense.
And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went in at halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Into the hands of Sanders. And he'll be out of bounds after a gain of about 5. That stops the clock, but slow and steady won't win the race at this point. 5 yards remain on second down.
He'll look to throw. He's going to look deep for Watkins. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and in the second quarter, he may very well run by him, but in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of...
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to almost certainly win the football game. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. So in a driving rain, he steps up, puts it through just like he's practicing in a gym somewhere.
How about that? Any little slip in this weather is going to throw him off. He stepped up there like it was perfect conditions, took dead aim, and knocked it through.
Hey. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One to...
And it looked like he got the feet down, did he? Yes, it's a catch. A big connection on that one. 35 yards.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. With 1 second to go, this to send us to overtime. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Airing it out deep for Smith. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Oh, no. He lost the football. And the Eagles come up with a late turnover. But it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed